Hello, I'm Mr. Arnigini, retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. I'm not a theologian who went to the Oxford University or Cambridge University to study dead letters and became a doctor of theology and all that nonsense. These people are super donkeys carrying holy books, and they have no idea of Christianity. They only know dead letters, and dead letters are not gospel. Gospel is hidden under the dead letters of the scripture. So here is it, St. Thomas, or Christ Thomas, as he was known in India, South India, and those who were his brethren, they were not known as Christian, they were known as Christ. And Portuguese Pope went there, and then he said, oh, Christ Jesus, only Christ Jesus, nobody else. So he killed those people who were calling themselves Christ, and they were proclaimed as heretic. And that's how the Christianity was killed, burning at stake and other things, as you know it. So in Jesus, unless you are a Christ, master of your own destiny, a male, you cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Kingdom of heaven is different from the royal kingdom of God. It's not the same. And these blind people in the universities, they have no idea between the two. So here is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis outside. And here is the royal kingdom of God, which is in your heart, and not outside. And those, the hypocrite temple priest, they wanted to incite Pilate so he can kill Jesus by telling them he is a rebel king. And they were saying he was proclaiming the royal kingdom of God, so of course he was the royal king. But they did not know the difference between king and royal king. So they used that word, you know, to incite the Pilate that he is proclaiming himself to be the king. And we want you to be the king, not this man to be our king. And then when Pilate asked Jesus, why they are calling you king? What type of king you are? Then Jesus asked Pilate, is this question coming from your own heart or somebody else has told you? Then Pilate retorted, do you think I am a Jew? So the Jewish people, they put that question. And when Jesus explained to him, if my kingdom was of this nature outside like yours, my soldiers would have come to fight against you. But mine is royal kingdom. It is within my own heart. It is not outside, it is inside me. And when Pilate understood the gospel truth, then he went to the Jewish people to tell them he had done nothing wrong to be crucified or punished. He's innocent man. But they shouted at him that we want not this man, we want Barabbas, a robber, to be released. And they got the release of robber, and then the Pilate gave up. He said, okay, take this man and do your own way. That means you go and do your own justice. And that's what they did, they crucified him. So Pilate washed the hand under the sun, primary source of light, that have nothing to do with the blood of this man. So that is the royal kingdom here, kingdom of heaven and hell here, which was under the rabbis. This is the royal priest, have solitary royal priest. So it is within our own heart, and we are not Christian of the book or anything. We are Christ, and we receive His word through logical reasoning. So many people have tried to explain this logo 114 of Thomas. Unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. And they don't have the idea of royal kingdom of God. They just put kingdom of heaven, which is wrong. So this is this thing. John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. That was his name, was Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was sired by Yahweh. So they were men of spirit who realized that when they become Jew outwardly, then they break their covenant with Abraham. This stepfather called Oregon, he tried to build the covenant of Jews with Abraham. He said he can't build it because Abraham was not a Jew outwardly. So he did not know what is the difference between inward and outward. A Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual, not outwardly a physical self. Now recently there's Lord Sachs, who died in last year in November, and Sachs was the temple priest. He had gave a seminar in Oxford, Lady Margaret Hall, and I attended that one, and I asked him question. A Jew is a spiritual self, inwardly, not outwardly. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. But the people of Judah tribe, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, they were born, they died. To this he answered, a Jew is both physical and spiritual. How could he be physical and spiritual both? But there were about 100 professors, university professors, sitting there. None was astonished at his statement, because they are super blind. And none of them came to me to tell us more about these things. That means they are too proud with their degrees in theology. And I am a retired lecturer in metallurgy. So white and black men, and why should they come to me to ask question? Inferiority complex killed them. So I call them super donkeys carrying holy books in the university professors. And one of their professors retorted, our duty is to teach the letters of the Old and the New Testament, or make the student drunk with the old wine of the dead letters. Desireth not the new. And our duty is not to do interpretation, it is up to the student to do it. So that is the knowledge they have. However, here it is, how a female become a male. Here the people are under the domination of their rabbi. He teaches them the moral law. So John the Baptist or Prophet Elijah, the cornerstone of the temple, he was ousted out by the hypocrite rabbis, because he could not face the hypocrisy. Only Christ Jesus can expose the hypocrite through teaching the moral law. So the moral law was the regime of John the Baptist. That's why he said Herod marrying the wife of Philip is immoral, which the temple priest would not declare it, because they were stooges of Herod. And so those people who were under the rabbis, they were female, dominated by him, as Saul was dominated by Rabbi Gamaliel. He will do whatever his rabbi will tell him to do. He had no freedom. While in Christ Jesus, we are free men. So, after that, you know, when they realized it was people of spirit, they came to John the Baptist to be baptized, become son of Abraham. And then they were seeking to become the son of the Most High, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And this is the narrow gate, solitary. On solitary basis, they have to enter this one. And they can only become solitary when they are spiritual, because this is a spiritual, purely physical, moral, spiritual. To become spiritual, you have to bury the ego of your tribal seed. Some are Judah tribe, Benjamin, Levi tribe. You must bury it and turn it into a plant. And the plant is twice born. And that will bear fruit. Seed can't bear fruit. And the plant gets grafted to the true vine, Christ Jesus, and bear fruit. So, here, when you are the disciple of the rabbi, as Saul was of Gamaliel, you are a female. And when you become independent, solitary, you are male, spiritual male. Spiritual male is neither male nor female, not Jew nor Gentile. But we are all sons of the Most High, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Our soul is concerned, not physical body. So here are all sons of the Most High. Whether in body you are a female or a male, doesn't matter. So these twice born are the people who are scriptural male. And this happened with Saul when he was disciple of John the disciple of Gamaliel. Then Gamaliel dominated him like husband dominates his wife. So Saul was the wife of Gamaliel. Whatever he told, he did it. And if you want to go in more detail, then watch my video on Matthew 19, marriage and divorce. Over there I explain it in detail. So when his conscience was not happy what he was doing, his inner man was saying, hey, what you are doing is wrong. But as he was the disciple of Gamaliel, he was his master, so he had to do it in order to be obedient disciple. The root of the disciple is discipline, and that Gamaliel was disciplining him by teaching the moral of Moses. In Christ Jesus, we don't have disciples. We are twice born people. We are laborers and workers, and not disciples. So Jesus then had pity on him. And in Damascus gate, there's lightning. He enlightened him. He set him free of the clutches of Gamaliel. And when that scale came off his eyes, thickness of the scale is representing the thickness of darkness that Gamaliel had created in his heart. So when they came off, he could see the reality of everything in Holy Spirit. Then he changed the name of his wife, Saul, to Paul, because it was a remarriage to his divorced wife, which he had given to Gamaliel and had reoccupied it, regained it, redeemed it from the clutches of that Gamaliel and gave it a new name, Paul. As a woman, you know, when she is married and she divorces the husband, then she get a new surname, Mrs. So-and-so. Say Mrs. Smith divorces and marries a man called Jones. So she would be known as Mrs. Jones. So that's how Saul became Paul. I hope this will make clear, but it is very easy for the man of spirit, for the people who are dead in the dead letters, as the university professors are, it is not easy. They can't understand it. That's why the gospel was delivered to, good news of the birth of Jesus was delivered to the shepherd looking after their sheep in the wilderness from the wolves. And they were devoted shepherds. And the good news was delivered to them and not to the temple priest who were living in comfortable houses, as today you find these dog hollow priests comfortably living in a church house. And wherever they get more money, they just run away from that and take the other position. So they are not devoted as the rabbis were devoted to their congregation. So they are worse than rabbis. From the yoke of which Jesus set us free, they fulfill Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Much more, you can understand everything through Holy Spirit. You can't get gospel without Holy Spirit, which is common sense. So exercise common sense and think logically, and you will brew logo, and logo is His word. And then you enter the royal kingdom of God. You become a master of your own destiny. Whatever people say, you don't bother. You face God. Your back is toward public. When you preach gospel, they won't understand it. I have been called heretic by the dog hollow priest in Reading. One called me heretic in his congregation. I was sitting there, and the passage came, "You can't love mammon and God at the same time." So he then started his sermon by telling his congregation sitting in the church, "There's a man among you sitting who teaches his own version." And I used to give them a leaflet like this, you know, to the people. "Don't take anything from him. He's a heretic. And take only things which have the stamp of the church." So they were bound by them. I was a free man giving my own literature, but they were not free men, so they could not honor me. They just took it out of obligation, but threw it away. So it did not bother me. When I write something, I learn, and that learning no money can buy. Invaluable. It's a revelations. So you should not bother what the people say. You should say that pleases our Father. Whereas the politician, the dog or the priest, they say what pleases the public. Otherwise, dog or priest, if he preach gospel, or the politician speak gospel truth. He cannot be elected. Gospel truth is bitter. Not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. Let any priest or a politician declare it from the stage and see how the people jump at him. Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. Physical self is the Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, Judah tribe, so and so. Tribal people. Tribal people born, tribal people died, not spiritual per self. Not a Hindu, Sikh or Muslim ever born or died. Our Father God bless you.